Now that we did our stakeholder analysis and we have an idea of who's important, we want to understand what gaps there are as it relates to this need for each of those stakeholders. So again, we go back to our list of resources, and I think, okay, where can I get really smart about the needs of each of these stakeholders as it relates to collecting lung cancer tissue? Out of all the resources that I have listed, we might start with UpToDate instead of Google. So in UpToDate, I did a search for lung cancer. Very simple. And on the left-hand side, you'll see things like intro, selection of modality for tumor biopsy. That's really similar to saying, how do you collect tissue? So I selected that, and there is a list in UpToDate of different approaches. And I noticed there's bronchoscopic approaches, so conventional bronchoscopy. I'm going to read that. There's other types of endobronchial ultrasound. There's fine needle aspirations and core biopsies. And so I'll read through this document, and again, to help organize my thinking, I'll make a list of the different methods to collect tissue sample, a description of that method, the stakeholder who completes that procedure and uses that tool, the strengths and weaknesses of each of those methods, and I might, along the way, keep brainstorming ways to refine my need. So for example, in my case, I put bronchoscopy, thoracic needle aspiration, and endoscopic ultrasound-guided fine needle aspiration as three options. I describe it, who does it, couple strengths, and it made me think, wow, for some of these, that turns out they puncture people's lungs, maybe there's an opportunity to find a new product that doesn't puncture patients' lungs in order to get their tissue. Something to take note of when I'm thinking about refining my need.